We're privileged to have Dale as our demonstrator. He's an award-winning watercolorist, and he's here to demonstrate for us his painting. And you're all welcome to come in closer and watch during his demonstration. So welcome, Dale.
And it's going live on Facebook right now.
So, dirty jokes?
No. I do have a joke page.
Why do you look at me and ask?
I carry a joke page with me.
What the?
Okay. I want to thank you for having me here today. I did put up some examples of my work over here on the windowsill. They're Giclée prints, museum quality. They're from different areas, from Illinois to Upper Peninsula, Michigan, and northern Wisconsin. I usually charge $80 for them, but if you are interested, it's $60 for today. So, and there's only one flower painting up here. When I finished that, my wife took it from me immediately, so I had to have prints of it done. So she owns it, I don't. So what
did she pay you?
Huh?
Oh,
he got paid.
I get paid eventually. What I'm doing here today is a watercolor of a winter scene of kind of a shed. It's about 2 miles, 3 miles south of us in northern Wisconsin. And it's a farmer that kind of builds where he feels he wants something. Everything's kittywampus on his property. And this is just an open shed where he stores his tractor and logs and God knows what else. But during the summer, we usually see bears running in and around through there. So that's how I'll be demonstrating. So if you want to come up closer, you'll be able to see better. So what I'm doing, I have 300-pound watercolor paper here, and it's 300-pound cold press. And I'm using burnt sienna, raw sienna, cobalt blue, ultramarine blue, lizard crimson, and sap green. And there's a couple different ways you can work your watercolors. You can work them wet on wet or wet on dry paper. I'm only going to wet just a little bit of the upper portion of the painting. And I'm going to begin by first putting my glasses on. Oh, that's what I'm doing. Okay. And I'm going to take a little bit of this sap green and some of the cobalt blue. And I'm going to begin washing in. I'm not worried about drips or anything for the most part. But I'm working from light to dark. And I'm going to be painting around the shed at first because it does have snow on top. And I'm putting in colors that I need to show because when I go back up on top of this, I want some of these colors showing through. If you have any questions, please ask. So I'm blocking in the pine tree that's off on the left-hand side here. And while this is wet, I'm going to introduce a little bit of cobalt blue in here. That will kind of dissipate and give it a different look to it. But I try to combine as many things as I possibly can in the first pass through the painting. So I'm going to take some cobalt blue, a little bit of the green, and the foreground is somewhat in shadow. so I can encompass the whole foreground and a little bit into the background, but not too much. And now I'm going to go into the shed part. But I'm still going to retain the integrity of the snow that's up on the roof of the shed at this point. Just a little bit of texture up in here. And I'm gonna go back into the background at this point. Put a little bit bolder look to it. But what I put down initially will show through here and there. I'm using the side of my brush a little bit more at this point to get the texture of the pine trees.
Did you mix that green or is it a straight color?
I used the sap green in here to start with.
Yeah.
And then I'm adding the blues and the browns to it.
To darken.
To darken it, yeah.
Okay.
So I pay a little bit more attention to the tops of the trees. This is still wet in the background up here, which is good because I want to retain that softness of those trees in the background. And while it's still wet, I can still go in and maneuver a few things in here. I have some trees down at the bottom that are somewhat on the softer side, so I'm using a real sponge to lift a few things that I can play that color off of. But I'm always telling the students, when you're painting a painting, make sure the background stays back. You don't want it coming forward. A lot of them like to add too much to it too quick. And I'm always saying, paint the painting, don't paint the photograph, which is important. Sometimes I add a little bit of water with the toothbrush. Just to give a little bit of softness to it. And while this is still wet, I'm going to go in here and add some more darkness to this. Taking some pure pigment at this point just to give this a little bit more color. That way I don't have to touch the paper itself. It just sort of is on there. And it will dissipate a little bit, give it a little bit different flavoring. before I go into the big tree, I'm gonna put in a little bit more color to foreground. And I'm adding some greens and so forth into that to pull the color in from the background, because it can't be too blue. Give that a little bit of a spray up front. Now I'm waiting, when you are working in watercolor, everything is in the timing, so I'm waiting for a certain area to dry up here, which this is pretty close. But while that's drying, I'm gonna put in some things that are down here at the base of the tree. And now I'm gonna go up into the tree. You really want your painting to come together quite quickly. You don't want to be dawdling around with little excessive detail. Now I'm going to go in and put in the pine needles of the bigger tree off in this area here, which will be much darker. I want to tap the brush off just a little bit. And every three or four brush strokes, I'm trying to change the color or the temperature or the value or the intensity of what I'm putting on here. So I'm creating a larger mass in here. It doesn't have to be distinctive of what it is, but I just need to put it in at first. Now that I have that in, I'm going to go in and put in some of the branches and let them dissipate in here a little bit. So you start to see the tree taking form a little bit better and allow the branches to weave in and out of the pine tree itself. And I'm going to go in and lift out just a little bit for the light to hit right there. And this will add some of the spikes to the pine tree just a little bit. I'm going to go into the building at this point. And this building really reaches pretty far back, deep-wise. I was amazed how much stuff he had in there. But he had some piles of this and piles of that. Just trying to keep that kind of held back a little bit. Don't want too much going on in there.
Okay.
questions at all? Any answers?
It's fascinating to watch.
What's that?
Fascinating to watch.
Oh.
Do you have a favorite subject matter that you paint?
Nature.
Just anything in nature?
Yeah.
A la natural.
When I was when I was younger, my parents had bought property up in northern Wisconsin after staying at a resort for so many years. And they bought 200 feet on the lake down in, on the same lake, about a mile down from where we were vacationing on a resort. And my mother fell in love with the house next door. And the carpenter didn't want to sell, he wanted to continue building on different things. And my dad finally approached him and says, would you be interested in trading deeds on the property and I'll buy the house? It's the first time he talked to my dad. He got down off the ladder because he was finishing up the cabinets and he says, that's a deal, so $25 down and a handshake sold the house. That was back in the day. They don't do that anymore.
That was 1900.
That was 1958. That was before you had to get lawyers involved.
There you go.
Okay. But that's that was my introduction to the North Woods of Wisconsin.
Just the scenery or animals too that
we have a long cabin up there now.
Do you do like painting wise, do you do animals?
I do animals.
He does birds a lot.
Birds. I've done pigs or a pig.
I did a pig.
I've done bears,
sure.
But we have bears, wolves, coyotes, deer, everything on our property.
Did you pay?
Yeah, what?
Yes, no, did you pay? I'm the only list.
But I spent every summer up there as a kid, which was nice. So now I'm dry brushing on some of the pine boughs.
Yeah.
have somebody from New York State watching me right now. I just think it's so cool.
How was the snow out there?
Miserable, big sun.
Yes, it keeps coming more, and they expected everything to be out.
Yeah. They're getting it. It's terrible.
I did something. Oh, because I'm beautiful.
Oh, it's because you're on time lapse. You're on that video.
Oh, I missed.
So now, try
it. Easy.
Always telling the students, don't rush through the painting. I usually sit and wait while it dries, and that's where you kind of gain your patience of watching the paint dry. That's a job in itself. But my students don't like to watch it dry. They want to rush ahead.
Hurry up and get it done.
Well, nobody dies if you don't finish it on time, is what I tell them. That's one good thing about it. So now I'm adding a little bit more intense color to this over here to get some of the movement of the snow. And then I'll go into the barn, develop that a little bit, and then put the rest of the trees in. But since we don't want the eye to fall off on the right-hand side, I'm going to darken that in a little bit because our eyes read from left to right on the painting. And if you put something a little bit too interesting over there, the tendency is for the eye to fall out. Not actually, but it will have a tendency of following right out to somebody else's painting.
Pretty good.
Okay. Now, I do have an oil brush here that I use occasionally for lifting, and I want to lift out a few things back in here. And you can do this, you can scrub the paper and not have too much harm happen to it. But I want a little bit of light coming back here. So I'm pulling up the first layer of the watercolor. And I did this one time on a paper called Indigo. It's a very soft handmade paper from India. It's about a 240-pound pound paper. And I went right through the paper, and I was doing a demonstration, which is not the smartest thing to do in a demonstration, is to start with something you haven't used before. But I did it.
I bet you didn't do it again.
Nope, didn't do it again. And all the students were like, oh, you make mistakes too. I says, all the time. Okay, one thing about, I'm using alizarin crimson and burnt sienna, and I can go in here and almost make a barn red. This is actually some sort of tractor in here. I've been getting away from the cadmium colors so that I don't have to worry about any poisoning or anything like that. A lot of people don't worry about it, but after you use it so many times, I have pulled away from them a little bit. I still use some of them, but I'll use the azo yellow colors. And I don't overmix my colors on my palette. I try to keep them lightly mixed. Because one of the beauties of watercolor when you work with them is when you put down a brush stroke, you have various colors happening right off the bat. And you don't have one color happening. I've seen students act like they're a mix master, mixing up the color, going crazy. Just want to develop this building just enough that it takes some note of what's going on here, but it doesn't take away from the nature part of the painting. Putting a few accents of color up in here. Okay, now what I'm going to do at this point is I'm going to put in these drips here I had originally. Those are going to become trees. I was going to have trees over there, but I'm moving them off to a different spot, which is working. Bless you. And as a watercolor, you have to be semi-flexible anyways, because you always have something happening that wasn't supposed to. Isn't that right, Kathy?
Right.
You should have said no, that never happens to you.
She flips through that paint like it's nothing.
This was the most aggravating thing I had to learn in college.
This?
Yes. I mean, I had a hard time with life drawing, but transparent watercolor was terrible. I painted about close to 500 paintings before I got one good one.
Been painting for 26 minutes.
What? No, but that's in the eye of the beholder.
Well, it was in the eye of the instructor. He did tell me.
Get a new teacher.
He did tell me just before Christmas, I had turned the corner and I have one good exercise, which I was very happy about. But on the way to the train station, I was thinking about what he said. I go, he never said painting, he said exercise. And those who had my instructor, Kathy had my instructor, Irv Shapiro, and I, and my wife had him. He's kind of an interesting person.
We have somebody from the Middle East watching you now, too.
How's the snow over in the Middle East?
I don't know.
Okay, just asking.
He wanted the camera closer to your artwork, so I did that. His language is kind of
different. But he was a good instructor, a good teacher, outstanding watercolorist. He even had a good sense of humor enough to hire me to teach there, so.
A compliment.
Yep.
Yes.
Taught there for 22 years.
Wow.
Almost there.
If you would like to be on Dale's mailing list, if you're not, fill out your email and your name. Also, if you do that, we're going to send you a free online watercolor course. All you have to do is, we'll send you the information, you just have to sign up. So if you're willing to learn on a computer, like Ann Noldeen tried.
I did.
Yes.
I tried.
I'm not computer literate like my wife is, so. She's the brains in the house.
You better not turn your own phone.
My brains in the brush.
I just learned how to text, so I don't feel bad.
You have to learn how to text when you got grandkids.
Oh.
That's right. That's how I learned.
Yeah. Because that's all they do. They go and
text. That's it.
I don't understand on how they can text and talk and walk at the same time. Okay, let's take a little bit of snow here. I'm going to take a little bit of gouache. It's not illegal. And I'm going to add a few accents of color here and there.
Okay, I'm going to start the raffle.
Okay.
And besides the painting, we're going to have the jelly bean jars.
Just a little bit of snow.
Should I bring them up front or?
Fine, I think everybody's fine.
Okay. And whose toothbrush is it?
Huh?
It's your wife's, right?
That's my wife's. I clean it when I'm done.
Oh, you want six?
Is that why she puts them twice?
Oh, I wish.
All I know is her plaque has gone away.
Your name?
I'm the same.
Sure.
I didn't tip that over. Yeah.
This is when get back.
You want to move your chair, please?
Where'd she go? I'm right here.
Oh.
No.
The paper was in
it. It's medium.
Oh.
I need to sit away. I'm just wearing a kind of my closet that I don't want giving away.
Thank you.
Looks good.
May I see?
You can see the deer in the back.
How many do you want? Sure. What do you want? Oh, you're going to get six of them. I got to go get my money, too.
If I sign up and give you my email.
I'm shaky today. At the last
you're going to get an email from Dale.
Okay.
And I don't know what that means.
I'm
shaking. Somewhere in our school.
There you go.
Okay. And all you have to do is sign up and you have to pay for free forever. And you can watch it on the computer.
Because I think you have my email.
Okay, but I just if you want the class, I need that.
Okay.
All right. Smile, Kathy.
Over there.
To keep the phone charged, because video sucks.
I see all that.
Yeah, it's like 50%.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna get.
I gotta get a picture of it all finished now.
That's all right. I spent 3 hours with him on the phone the other day with mine. Mine was crapped out too. Mine was just slower than hell.
And I'm so spent. I have my boat.
Double whammy.
Hi, where was that, Don?
It was in Galena, Illinois. Except there was a asphalt road, and he, artist prerogative, he changed it so it was and
more natural. More natural, right?
Well, it looks more like it was during the Civil War then.
Well, okay, this is my. Okay, coming from the East Coast.
Yeah.
That's the Chesapeake Bay. And that is a little road that goes up on Calvert Beach, a tiny beach that nobody knows about. And that was where my neighbor's little cottage was in the summer when we were little tiny girls and we used to play.
Isn't that crazy?
Yes.
It's lovely.
I don't want to
thank
walk
you.
In front of you.
Yes, you do.
Oh, it's not you.
It's a Facebook Live.
Well, there you go. I had nowhere to get your advice from.
Oh, I got five. Six coming.
Yeah, I always treat them as kids.
Yeah,
you
signed
up. Okay. Thank you.
How long have I been there?
Well, every day is a blessing.
Mildred Davis was also in the
class. So you signed up for his online class?
Yeah, I saw.
Okay. For my banking.
And did you sign up? Did you sign up for his online class, the free class?
No, I don't have email.
Okay.
Okay, then go down.
Thank you.
Oh,
let's see.
And she's got the tickets.
Yep.
Okay.
Who's got the tickets? Fran's walking around.
You got the bag. Where's Jen?
I don't know.
She's got the...
She ran away.
I need...
All right. We're going to close this. Dale, say goodbye.
Goodbye.